Warning: read and follow all labels and the owner's manual. To protect yourselves and others from injury, it's important to go through a safety checklist before operating an Oxy-Fuel system. Always use personal protective equipment. Oxy-Fuel torches are capable of producing a 6,000 degree Fahrenheit flame, molten metal, ultraviolet rays, and they can shoot sparks over 50 feet. Therefore, it is absolutely necessary to use the proper protective gear. Wear approved face and eye protection. The minimum shade level for cutting steel is shade 5, while shade 3 is acceptable for brazing and soldering operations. Light rays from cutting, heating, and welding processes produce intense ultraviolet and infrared rays that can burn eyes and skin. When working with torches, you should also wear flame-resistant clothing, such as a long-sleeve welding jacket, leather gloves, and protective shoes. Keep all clothing free of oil and grease. When operating a torch, avoid wearing synthetic fabric. Instead, wear natural fibers such as leather, wool, or cotton. Avoid cuffed pants or loose pockets that slag of molten metal could fall into. And be sure not to carry lighters, matches, or other combustibles. Next, ensure proper use of equipment. Always perform a visual inspection to check the quality and condition of the equipment. Check that levers and valves work properly, and that threads and regulators are clean with no grease or oil. Many hazards can be eliminated by simply being aware of what condition the equipment is in. Take advantage of safety devices such as check valves, flashback arresters, and regulator hard hats. If a flashback arrester is installed, a check valve is not necessary. Using both at the same time can reduce gas flow and negatively affect torch operation. It's also important to inspect the work area for safety hazards. Before you begin any torch application, always take a moment to simply look around. Check out the area you're about to work in to make sure the area is clear and all combustibles are 35 feet away. It's also important to never cut, weld, or braze on closed containers that may have held combustible materials such as gas, oil, or other potentially explosive chemicals. Always keep an approved working fire extinguisher on hand in case of a fire. Always follow the proper operational procedures designed for the type of equipment you are using. Make sure the regulator adjusting screws are in the off position before opening the cylinder valve. Always purge the system before igniting the torch. To purge, open the torch fuel valve and let fuel run through the system for just a few seconds. Then close the fuel valve and repeat the process for the oxygen side of the system. Be sure to have the right cylinder size that supplies a sufficient gas flow and pressure for the tip being used. Never use acetylene at pressures greater than 15 pounds per square inch. Never use oxygen as a substitute for compressed air. Never use oil on regulators, torches, fittings, or other equipment in contact with oxygen. And finally, do not attempt to alter or repair Oxy-Fuel equipment yourself. Always store and shut down equipment properly. Cap unsecured compressed gas cylinders. Shut off compressed gas supply when not in use. Never transport cylinders in an enclosed vehicle. While it's taken some time to explain all the safety precautions and procedures that we've discussed here, it really only takes a few seconds to follow each of them. And doing so can eliminate injuries or even save your life. Be sure to check out the rest of the videos in our how-to video series to learn how to safely and effectively operate Oxy-Fuel equipment.